what's on the gearbox and the fuel line. So underneath the car, the carbon in oil. Because whenever John tops up the peeps, the oil just goes through the suspension bearing and comes out the other side and gets on the wheel and just gets sprayed all the bumper on the underneath the car. So you've got to leave this spoiler. His attitude is, look, it's better to have too much oil than not enough, because he's absolutely correct. So he always tops them up. But you look on the inside of the wheel, there's this big pack of oil. It's just a freaking safe.
But that's not what it's written.
I'll try and look around for a copy. It is, it's pretty rare, but it comes up now and then through like the sort of place. It's got the original panels which had the opening hatches to maintain the window temperature mechanism. Whereas all these cars, these three standard cars have got these white luminous panels. I just put them straight over the top. And as well, they put the luggage racks down and to put bigger advertising posters up. So if you take these panels off, the original panels will be underneath. That's what 3102 still has. 3102, I think, had these panels, had to take them off when it was repainted back to brown in 1980. Yeah, they just put plain metal panels. That's why it's got those plain metal panels. Originally, it had the, originally they all had the same cast aluminium panels that 4790's got now. And 4554, I think, has also got. But when it was Brown and Prima Doll car, they didn't have any, so they just laid up the pine metal panels to cover up those holes. So they should go if we have enough of those cast panels to go around. But yeah, so you take these panels off, you'll see the old panels and the original should still be in the record. Thank you.
Thank you.